Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens.
This is Pastor Jolly John Lukomski, and I have at my side
Pastor Matt Youngblood Clark.
And together we are
Wrestling with the basics.
And what we'd like to share with you this Christmas, these 12 days of Christmas, is some of our favorite things about Christmas. And Matt, I think you're going to start us off here.
What's one of your favorite things about Christmas? One of my very favorite things about Christmas is the Angel Gabriel. The Angel Gabriel comes up right before Christmas, actually.
Yeah.
We see that appearance of Gabriel. Gabriel, who is an angel, and an angel, that word means
messenger.
Very good, messenger. And Gabriel has some good news to deliver right before Christmas. And that first piece of good news that Angel Gabriel delivers is to Zechariah,
yeah, we did his story on our last full episode, didn't we?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that is archived, I believe, on the KFUO website.
You can actually go listen to that if you're looking for something to do while you're on vacation. Sure, check out all of the archived shows on Wrestling with the Basics and all of the shows here on KFUO.
That's right. Last Saturday, though, if you listen to the whole thing, you'll be rewarded with a little plane of a jalapeno course.
Almost didn't get it in, but we snuck it in at the last minute thanks to Matt. He's the young guy. He remembers all that stuff.
That's right. That's why they call me Youngblood.
Well, we got to get at this.
Okay, yeah. So Luke chapter 1, beginning with verse 19. And in fact, we're just going to read verse 19. This is after Zechariah is in the temple and questions, well, how am I going to have a child?
I'm an old man. I'm not having any babies. I'll tell you that right now.
Okay. And this is Gabriel's answer to Zechariah.
And the angel answered him, I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God, and I was sent to speak to you and to bring you this good news.
It's good news. Good news that Gabriel is delivering. So, yeah, an angel, a messenger. This message of good news from God for Zechariah.
Why is this your favorite thing, though, Matt?
Well, I think it's coupled with another piece of good news.
Okay.
Even better news, I would say, John. So let's skip down to verse 26, if you want to start reading there, where Gabriel visits someone else.
Ah.
A young woman named Mary.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel, again, was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you. But she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, but he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end.
Isn't that something? I wonder if Gabriel was excited about delivering these pieces of news. I wonder if there was, you know, the angels were fighting over who got to do this job. Can you imagine that? I mean, the good news of John the Baptist to Zechariah, but even more so the good news, the greater news, the best news the world's ever heard of a Savior, Jesus, born to a virgin named Mary. Boy, an even greater miracle than a child born to an older couple is a child born to a virgin. And not only is this child going to be the son of Mary, but also the son of God. Boy, how excited Gabriel must have been.
I think so. In fact, if you think about it, this is the very reason that angels were created as messengers. They were waiting to deliver this message for years and years and years.
That's right. And so here's Mary's reaction, and we'll wrap up with this, verse 34.
And then Mary said to the angel, how will this be since I'm a virgin? And the angel answered her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called holy, the Son of God.
Okay, very good. So Zechariah, he reacts with some skepticism and distrust. Mary, she asks about the details, but she answers with faith. And she bursts forth then in song, the Magnificat, giving glory and praise to God. So I think one of the takeaways for me, and hopefully for our listeners, is that just as Gabriel was a message of that good news, sharing that Savior's birth, so also we have that same privilege, right, of being those messengers of that same good news of a Savior born for us, a Savior born for the world, Son of Mary and Son of God, Jesus Christ.
Are you saying that all of us are going to be Christmas angels, Matt?
I don't know about the halo, John, but yes, Christmas messengers of that greatest news of all.
And we all wish you a blessed Merry Christmas. This has been
Wrestling with the Basics.